SpO2, 96%.
The pulse of a Marine shock trauma platoon can be tense.
You got the vitals.
Having an independent duty corpsman on staff like HM2 Sean Henby helps ease the strain.
I'll check the tube, I'll check the head. We're kind of prepared to be either sent out by ourselves onto a ship with the Marines, or sometimes even just go sit around in a clinic and see patients all day. So we kind of have to get trained up in how to do everything medical-wise. All right, let's go.
Henby recently attached to Okinawa's 3rd Medical Battalion and is participating in Exercise Crocodile Strike with Marine Rotational Force Darwin in Australia.
I just started off with them. I checked in a few months ago, and so this is a good breakdown for me.
With training scenarios like this, Henby and his medical team demonstrate how they would react in a real-world emergency event.
Lungs on the left, clear on the right.
We're here to kind of get them patched up, good to go, and stabilized, and hopefully not hold on to them for very long.
Factors like climate and logistics affect the way the platoon treats patients.
Not everything's going to be the same environment as it would be in Okinawa. It gets us prepared to kind of think of what we need to have on hand and how we need to be more prepared if we're going to be sent elsewhere overseas, and instead of just having everything in the backyard.
Whatever the mission, medical teams and patients find themselves in good hands with corpsmen like HM2 Henby.
One, two, three, lift.
Staff Sergeant Mike Larman, Northern Territory, Australia.
Let's go.